Our city council regular meeting to order Tuesday, June 4th. Would you please stand with me and please raise the flag.
Please raise the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call, Deb.
Nelson?
Yes.
Matt?
Yes.
Rexbro?
Yes.
Good Child?
Yes.
Yes.
Motion to approve the agenda.
Second.
Motion made second to approve the agenda. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. I'd like to welcome everybody in the chamber today. And I see Bev is here and from the Sentinel and particularly you people that are watching over television. Today we've got a hearing right off the bat and it's an offer to purchase property. The council set this as a date and time to consider offers received by 5 p.m. on May 24th, 2019 for the south 609.85 east 283 of lot 5. The Mars Industrial Park South Edition, Mars, Iowa. It consists of about 2.81 acres. One written offer was received as follows and is provided separately. Neil Anthony has got an offer for $56,200. The property has a first right of refusal clause held by an adjoining property owner, namely Ellen and Sharon Pratt. The clause requires the city council first hold a hearing on all the offers, accept an offer, then notify Ellen and Sharon Pratt by certified mail. The Pratts then have 30 days to exercise their right to purchase by signing a purchase agreement under the same terms and conditions of the accepted offer. And Jason, I'm going to turn it over to you in regard to where we're at on what the next move is here.
You need to open the hearing or discuss it?
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. At this time I'm going to open the hearing and if there's any written or objections or comments, please state your name and the hearing is open at this time. I'll ask once again.
Al Pratt.
Oh, would you please, Al, step to the podium and state your name and address, please.
Al Pratt, okay. 601 Lombardi Road, Lamars. I just have a simple question. After the issues we had last year, or a little over a year ago, why would somebody want to move closer to my property?
I don't know as I can answer that. Why they want to, you know?
I guess I was even kind of considering why would you even want to consider this?
Mm-hmm.
So that's my only question.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, Al, if I could answer it, I would tell you.
Okay.
You know that.
Yep. Okay.
As to why or the reasons, I don't know.
Okay. Thank you.
You bet. Is there any other comments or concerns?
Neil?
Yeah.
The reason for looking at to purchase this ground is to expand our parking lot on the north end to the west. Since we closed our shop in Sioux Falls, we've added 25 more trucks to the Lamars location. And as you know, Dick, you've been out there a few times. It's
tight.
Crowded, yes.
It's tight.
Very, very crowded. So we need to do something. As far as moving close to the line pile, I guess it's been under my assumption that I've been told by the city that the line pile is going to be gone and is to be moved over to the Kellens. So there should be no issue with the line pile as far as I'm concerned.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
That's all I can tell you.
Thank you, Neil, I appreciate it. Any other questions or comments in regard to the hearing? Hearing or seeing none, I'm gonna close the hearing at this time. The administration.
Can Jason help us with some of the information?
Yeah.
Maybe you were asking him about.
Yeah, would you mind, Jason, giving us
What do you want to know? We got one offer. There is a first right of refusal that Alan holds on the property. Everybody can see by the map of what the property last time too. It's, yeah, it's the land in between what they both currently own. 2.81 acres. The offer is $56,200. It comes to $20,000 an acre. So I believe the asking price was $30,000 an acre. So it's under. Alan bought his at $30,000 an acre. So it is a reduced price.
So legally help me out here, Mr. Murphy. If we say we accept the $56,000 offer, Alan still has 30 days after we accept it?
That is correct, yes. And he can stand in their shoes and purchase it for the $56,200.
Sorry.
Is there any litigation between the two parties that we're aware of?
Not that I'm aware of, no.
Okay. Any other questions?
So you have three options there. Accept it, reject it, or continue with.
What does continue it do?
Continue it, then you could, you have one offer, so you could continue it to negotiate with Neil.
If you take that option, that's why we have the closed session at the bottom. There's no reason to discuss counter proposals.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it.
This or that. I mean, we'll do that at the end of this meeting in a closed session.
So, just to be very clear, the final accepted agreed purchase contract with Mr. Anthony, Al has 30 days to act on the final.
Correct. So, if you accept the offer from Mr. Anthony's today, we would be done with the council and be able to sell it in 30 days once that time has expired for Mr. Pratt.
But if we want to talk about a counter to Mr. Anthony, we're going to do that in closed session.
We can, but his offer can also go away.
Oh, I understand.
Okay.
That's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Yes.
I want to go into closed session. And I do not want to act on this at this point. There's a lot of moving parts here, folks, and we need to look this over pretty seriously.
So you're still
that'll be the final that'd be the motion on the bottom.
Then that's the motion I'll make. Motion to extend the public hearing for the sale of south 690.85 feet and the east 200.83 of lot 5 Lamar's Industrial Park South Addition to
18.
It is my motion, right?
Yeah, the next council meeting, 18th.
When is it?
Next council meeting is
June 18th. June 18th, 2019 council meeting, and negotiate the offer with the council to enter closed session at the end of this meeting.
Is there a second?
So moved.
Motion made and second to extend the public hearing on a sale of the south 609.85 east 200.83 of lot 5, Lamar's Industrial Park South Addition, to the June 18th, 2019 council meeting, and negotiate the offer with council to enter closed session at the end of the open meeting today. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
So now in Neil's offer, he had closing June 14th, so that may have to.
Well, we should, that's all parts of the purchase contracts.
Okay.
Closing included.
Either way, it'll come up with the next council.
Yeah.
Right.
And I want to be perfectly clear, I'm not opposed to selling, but I just think there's a lot of moving parts that we need to look at. So.
Okay.
Do you want to do that just as a council in the closed session, or do you want Neil here?
I think we're going to look at
And we're gonna hold a closed session right after this.
Yeah, and it's on the agenda.
It's already there, it's on the agenda. But if we have a number, a closed session, does Mike, does Neil have to get contact?
I think Jason would.
I'll contact her.
Okay, I just wanna make sure we're doing this.
And it's got to be set for another hearing if we have a different.
Yeah, the hearing will be continued to June 18th, then.
You understand? All right. Okay, moving on to the general discussion. We have our general discussion, we ask the individual to stand up to the plate and state your name and address. And I've got Kevin Vandevick, our police chief.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
Okay. Well, the past couple of weeks, Lamar's have been a difficult time for the community. And I'd like to, on behalf of the police department, ambulance service, and fire and rescue, thank the community for their patience and their understanding. Thanks for their support. It's nice to know that in these times of dramatic events, the community pulls together and they help each other out. Outside agencies come in and help, and I just wanna publicly thank the community and the outside agencies that have helped us through these difficult couple of weeks. We ask that the community continue to think of those recovering and suffering in these couple of instances. Maybe on a more of an upbeat note, I was hesitant to bring this up today, but I'm going to. Lamar's Police Department was recently chosen through the Iowa Chiefs of Police Association as a 2018 Community Policing Award recipient. Out of 700 communities in Iowa, this is very humbling for us. This award is for outstanding efforts in community policing, and these are efforts of our police officers and our support staff at the police station. So with that, Justin, if you can bring that up and show them. I accepted this award on May 23 at the annual conference in Iowa City. We would like to thank the officers and support staff in the department. Those are the true recipients of that award. What's unique about this is I think in a couple of years, we have become a model of what other departments want to do in the state of Iowa. And now I get phone calls and they ask what we're doing. So it's kind of cool how that's kind of transformed and turned around. So I just wanted to make you aware of that.
So. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. Before we go any further, I do want to say this, that due to the IV situation, I too, as mayor of this town, want to thank our sheriff's people, our police, fire, our EMS people, and our local police officers. I was very heavily involved personally in it, and the reaction time was absolutely unbelievable. The other thing, I did have an opportunity to go down and see the girls, visit the girls in Sioux City, and had the opportunity to meet their parents, and they were very, very amazed at what we've got going here in the Lamar's, and wanted to thank everybody. So as mayor, I felt it was my job to pass that news around. Okay, any other questions in regard to the discussion? Anybody else have anything? Getting done, John? Thumbs up, Ward?
Thumbs up to everyone involved in preparing for the sesquicentennial celebration.
Nothing.
I'd echo John. They're meeting the last organization meeting right now, and I think they've done an outstanding job of getting prepared, and I think we're going to have a great week.
Yep. Bex?
I'll pass.
Ken?
I'll pass, too. Thank you.
Okay, so we're moving on to the consent items. All items listed on the consent agenda will be enacted by one motion. There'll be no separate discussions on those items unless a request is made prior to the time the council votes on the motion. We've got three of them today. Approval of the May 21st, 2019 regular meeting minutes, a list of bills for the period ending 5/31/19, a renewal liquor license and outdoor service area for the Iowa Barbecue Company, El Tarasco, Tacos Lavandas, and Hy-Vee. Entertain a motion unless somebody wants to call any of these.
Motion to approve consent items 1 through 4.
Okay. one through three. Four was pulled, good.
Second.
Motion made in second to approve the consent items one through three. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carried. We didn't get the proper.
Just wear a bright shirt.
Okay, moving on to the action items. First one is KNSJB addition, final plat. On May 28th, 2019, the Planning and Zoning Commission approved the promise of the preliminary and final plats of KNSJB addition contingent on the private street being named on the plat. KNSJB addition is a replat of lots 1 through 5, block 1, in Pluger Industrial Park. The final plat, consisting of 17 lots, is attached. As with a recent development, a development agreement has been drawn to outline the developers' and city's responsibilities. The project will be bid and constructed by the developer, with the city contributing 50% of the cost to the construction to construct the city-owned public water main. A copy of the dealer development agreement has been attached. The administration does recommend the approval of the final plat and development agreement. Any questions?
There's one other change to this plat from what P&Z approved. You got their motion in that top paragraph of at least naming that private street, that east-west street. So that's done. But what's changed, the additional change on this plat is down in between lots 16 and 17, what P&Z approved was a 20-foot utility and drainage easement. This plat shows a 30-foot utility and drainage easement. So the additional 10 feet is because there's a required separation between the water and the sanitary sewer that's going to be put through there. So they needed the additional space to do that properly. So
that's what was, that's the change?
That's the change.
So as it's shown now, 30 is correct?
Yep, this is correct. It's just that is a change from what P&Z approved. P&Z approved it as a 20.
Okay, any questions?
Any questions on the development agreement is a little bit different. You know what we've had in the past with K&S on those three residential subdivisions was that it was bid on their end, the developer, and then the city's payback was that $4,300 per lot as they were sold. That was the deal on those three. So this one's different in the sense that not so much that they're still doing the bidding portion of it. It's just that the city's contribution will be to 50% of the public water main that's going to enter that site. So that's the difference in the development.
Any questions on that?
Our city ordinance requires if we have sanitary sewer that properties have to hook up if they're going to use it. Yeah. Is that because this is a private development, does that?
Yeah, what's going in there as a sanitary service, as a sanitary line, is going to be their private, basically private service line. Okay. So it won't be a city sewer main in there. It'll be private.
So if there's an issue on that line in that development, it would be the developer's responsibility to repair.
Yeah. And the reason for that is not every lot, depending on how things get built in there, not every lot may need sanitary. Not every lot may need water. But you know, so they'll hook up as needed to their private line.
I was at the meeting. I think the idea, and I think it's a good use of the land that's there, is for people that want to have a storage but I think it's a very good use of that land.
You guys are here, you wanna say your 2 cents so that.
Do you have anything else you wanna add to that?
Just to make sure we don't screw something up.
Hi guys, you know, we have Bruce Cullen, been here before. What he said, what Ken just said, it's kind of a different deal we're setting up, and hopefully this works out for the community for the smaller garages. And we do have a lot of public storage in there, it's gonna be in there too, but you have an opportunity to buy smaller lots in there and put on your own shed if you want to and that stuff, so.
A little flexibility program.
If you want to, yeah, so.
Any questions for?
You're also going to police the area so they don't get into a lot of weeds and.
Yeah, cause we will own most of the area in there, so, and it's in the covenants, you have to mow it, so all things have to apply to the city ordinances, mowing and all that stuff, so if you own one, you have to mow it, it's all part of that, the covenants is all part of the.
Fair enough.
The city ordinances.
And what's the zoning? Industrial.
Industrial now, yeah, we haven't changed the zoning on it.
No, I think.
Will you have covenants, or is it, everything's gonna follow this?
Yeah, there'll be some covenants as far as all the buildings, and then the HOAs will follow the city ordinance as far as mowing and stuff like that and all those things, if there is HOAs in there, so, on the private drive.
Thank you. And if you notice the lot 17, 16, and 15, I think 14, there is a waterway that's presently running down through there, and that will be put into underground culvert, two of them.
By the city, yes.
So that they can access those lots on Prospect Street.
Correct.
Yeah, and that is a 100% city project, and that'll be coming, I don't know if it'll be next council meeting, but maybe the one after that, because that'll have to go out for bids.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, sir.
That's kind of the question that we're covering at the zoning meeting, so.
If you have covenants,